starting and start completing.
Okay. So we'll talk about pros and cons of this. Kanban is mostly about visualizing, managing your flow, and limiting work in progress. Okay. So those are all the things which are pros of Kanban. Okay. So the first thing is the big information radiator. Means in Kanban you have a big visualization Kanban board. Okay. So everyone do not need to rush to people saying that what are you doing and when it will complete. Okay. It's already on the board. So everything should be on board and it's already communicating a lot of things, so it's information radiator. Second thing is limit on work in progress. Okay, so it says that don't start too many things. You need to have a limit of 3 or 4 things, okay, which is currently in doing state. Okay, so we can have many to do things, but doing the things which are in doing should be limited. Okay, so the focus is should be kind of means we need to complete that thing, more thing on the done side in Kanban. Okay, so that's about optimizing delivery of value with continuous integration. It's XP thing, but kind of implement in Kanban as well. It's optimizing the delivery of value, right? We only pick the things from the to-do things to doing, which means again it's a limited things in doing, which is actually delivering more value first to the customer. Okay, second thing is limited documentation, because everything is visualized, means everything is on the board. Okay, we need a limited documentation. We cannot say no documentation, but a limited documentation. Okay, then Kanban can be implemented from day zero. There are no kind of roles which are associated with Kanban. You can directly jumpstart Kanban, okay, means start implementing Kanban. You do not need to have kind of a scrum thing that I need to have a sprint, I need to have a scrum master role, I need to have product owner role. Okay, you can start implementing Kanban in any type of project from day zero. Okay, and then it's again, similar of third point, small increments of value can be visualized, right? We can actually see that what is getting done. Okay, means our doing state, what is getting done. Okay, coming to the cons or challenges of Kanban, mostly it's kind of a thing in our industry that it's used for support project, right? That's a project which has already completed the development thing and it's kind of in defect or in a maintenance mode, that uses Kanban. But it's kind of a myth. We can also implement Kanban in kind of a development project as well. Okay. The second thing is chaotic planning in Kanban experience. Means if you see the Kanban board, right, it just tells about to-do, doing and done. Okay. Means in doing we can have 3-4 more stages, right, in development, in testing, etc. etc. Okay. But Kanban doesn't say about where to plan. Okay. So it's planning is a kind of a chaotic experience and it can be a challenge in Kanban. Okay, second thing, spikes and POC is not given focus. Okay, means if you see the Kanban board, it's about kind of means to do things, okay, means doing and done, but there are many things which can directly come out from anywhere, right? And it becomes a priority from that point of time. Okay, so we can have a separate swim lane in Kanban for addressing that challenge, but Kanban doesn't directly give us a solution to that kind of spikes or a POC work. Okay, then means it's kind of a challenge that it's again a myth kind of thing that Kanban can't be a scale or can be mixed with other kind of Scrum or other kind of all the practices. Kanban cannot directly mix with that. Okay, means we have seen a kind of examples which Scrumban and all that, it can kind of mix with other environment as well. Okay, but it's seen as a challenge. Okay. Secondly, this is the biggest thing as a challenge is problem in distributed visualization. Okay, if you have a distributed team environment, okay, your team, one team is sitting in Pune, other team is sitting in Gurgaon. Okay, we cannot have that distribution, means we cannot have that visualization board. Okay, we can try to implement a kind of a pseudo visualization board or an online visualization board, but it doesn't always work or it doesn't always work like a physical board. Okay, so that's a bit of a challenge in kind of implementing Kanban in distributed team environment. And then cost of delay in delivering value. Okay, so again, the same thing means if it's a distributed environment, okay, there is a cost, means more cost related to delay, okay, where there is some kind of mixture or some kind of confusions happening between distributed team. Okay, so yes.
So does it kind of, prerequisite that it should be co-located team and
no, it's not a prerequisite, it's more of a challenge where we try to implement Kanban. Okay, it's